Namaste learners, this is Mukesh Amrutkar from Guru Gobind Singh College of Engineering and Research Center, Nashik. In today's session, we will learn about the communication systems part 2. In today's session, we will see the types of wired communication and what is meant by AM and FM. After today's session, learners will be able to draw construction of twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. Learners will be able to state applications of twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. Learners also able to define amplitude modulation and frequency modulation. Starting with the first, wired communication. So basically for wired communication, we have to use twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. Starting with the first, twisted pair cable. In twisted pair cables, twisting of wire is done as shown in figure. In this figure, you can observe that the wires are twisted, and that's why this cable is known as a twisted pair cable. Why we have to do this? This twisting of wire is done to reduce the effect of noise. There are two types of twisted pair cables: unshielded twisted pair cable and shielded twisted pair cable. First, consider the unshielded twisted pair cable. A twisted pair consists of two insulated conductors twisted together in the form of spiral as shown in figure. So here you can observe the spiral structure of the UTP, unshielded twisted pair cable. These UTP are very cheap and easy to install. UTP used for point-to-point communication as well as for point-to-multipoint communication. Next, shielded twisted pair cable. When we consider the shielded twisted pair cable, in STP, the pair of insulating conductors is covered by metal foil or metal shield as shown in figure. In this figure, you can observe the metal shield is given with the twisting of wires. That's why this is known as a shielded twisted pair cable. The STP cost is more as compared to UTP because of metal shield. So because of this metal shield, the cost of the STP will increase. The applications of twisted pair cables are in telephone line, LAN cables. We have to use twisted pair cables. Next, coaxial cables. So generally, coaxial cables, all of you have seen. The construction of coaxial cable is shown in figure. It consists of two conductors which are separated by insulator. Here, this is the conductor and this is also a conductor, which is nothing but a shield or braided outer conductor, which is insulated by using this insulator. Metal shield is used to avoid the electromagnetic interference. This metal shield is here used to avoid the EMI. Therefore, it has excellent noise immunity. Coaxial cables has large bandwidth. It is used for point-to-point or point-to-point multipoint communication. These cables costlier than twisted pair cables, but cheaper than fiber optic cables. These cables are easy to install. The applications of coaxial cables are cable TV, LAN, telephone network. All of you have seen the cable TV connection. That connector use is nothing but coaxial cable through which we have to connect the signals available for the dish connection. Next type of communication cable, that is fiber optic cable. When we consider the fiber optic cable, the construction of fiber optic cable is shown in figure. In this construction, we can observe that there is a core, outer side of that core there is a cladding, and at the last there is a jacket. So basically it consists of inner glass core surrounded by a glass cladding which has low refractive index. The light is transmitted through the optical fiber cable. So in this cable there is no flow of current. Here flow light passes through the fiber optic cable. Light is launched into the fiber using light source such as LED or laser. By using laser source or LED, we can launch the light into the fiber optic cable. It is detected on the other side using photo detector such as photo transistor. By using photo transistor or photo detectors, we can detect that light passing through the fiber optic cables. In a fiber optic cable, light is propagated in two modes, that is single mode or multimode. In single mode, light follows a single path through a core, whereas in multimode, the light takes more than two paths, more than one path through the core. When we consider the advantages of OFC, small size and lightweight, low cost, it is not affected by EMI, that is electromagnetic interference, large bandwidth, and there is no crosstalk in the fiber optic cable. Disadvantages of OFC are initial cost is high, joining the optical fiber is difficult. Applications of OFC for telephone line, then in LAN networks, OFC generally used. This is all about the wired communication media. Now, it's time to reflect. Let us pause the video and try to answer this question. State the different types of cables used for wired communication. In OFC, what is transmitted? I think all of you think on this question, and already we have seen the different types of cables used for wired communication, that is twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. And in OFC, what is transmitted? In OFC, light is transmitted. Next, we'll consider the what is meant by AM and FM. Before that, what is meant by modulation? So modulation is a process in which some parameters of carrier signal changes in accordance with the modulating signal. The parameter such as amplitude, frequency, or phase of carrier signal changes in accordance with the modulating signal. So generally, when we consider the carrier signal, carrier signals are the signals which has high frequency as compared to the modulating signal. So for modulation, we will require the basically two signals, that is modulating signal and carrier signal. And carrier signal is having a very high frequency as compared to the modulating signal. What is the need of modulation? So the modulation is used to reduce the height of antenna, to avoid the mixing of signals, to increase the range of communication, to make multiplexing possible, to improve quality of reception. What are the types of modulation? So depends on what we have to perform. There are three types of modulation: amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, and phase modulation. Let us consider the first, amplitude modulation. Starting with the amplitude modulation. So amplitude modulation is a process in which amplitude of carrier signal changes in accordance with modulating signal. So you can observe here in this figure, this is a modulating signal, this is a carrier signal, and this is amplitude modulated signal, that is AM modulated signal. So if you observe here, this amplitude of this carrier signal, this is a carrier signal, its amplitude is changes in accordance with this modulating signal. In this figure, modulated signal, we can observe this amplitude is changes. We already know that the amplitude is a vertical distance, that is distance on the y-axis. So here you can observe in amplitude modulated signal, here the amplitude of this carrier signal is changes in accordance with the modulating signal, that is called as a amplitude modulated signal. How it is mathematically represented? So amplitude modulated signal is mathematically represented as EAM is equal to EC into 1 plus M cos omega t into cos omega t, where EC is peak amplitude of carrier signal, M is modulation index, and that modulation index is given by M is equal to EM upon EC, where EM is peak amplitude of modulating signal and EC is peak amplitude of carrier signal. So in this way, we can define the amplitude modulation. Next, we have to consider the frequency modulation. When we consider the frequency modulation, It is a process in which frequency of carrier signal changes in accordance with the modulating signal. So here you can observe here, this is our modulating signal and this is FM modulated signal. So here the FM modulated signal, if you observe, its frequency, that is horizontal distance, is related with the frequency, because on the x-axis we have to consider the time, and time is related with the frequency, as we know that f is equal to 1 upon t. So here the frequency of this signal is changes with respect to modulating signal. In this period, when its amplitude increases, at that time the frequency of this signal changes. Okay, from this we can say that the frequency of this carrier signal is changes in accordance with the modulating signal. When we consider the frequency modulated signal, mathematically it is represented as EFM is equal to EC sine in bracket omega t plus MF sine omega t, where EC is the peak amplitude of carrier signal and MF is the modulation index for FM, and it is given as MF is equal to delta of an FM, where delta is frequency deviation while FM is the frequency of modulating signal. So in this way we can define the frequency modulation. So basically, when we consider the comparison between amplitude modulation and frequency modulation, first point is amplitude of FM wave is constant in FM, while in AM the amplitude of AM will change with respect to the modulating signal. In FM, transmitted power remains constant, while in AM transmitted power is dependent on the modulation index. Third point, all the transmitted power is useful. In AM, carrier power and one side band power are useless. Fourth point, in FM receivers are immune to noise, while AM receivers are not immune to noise. Next point, it is possible to decrease noise further by increasing deviation. In AM, this is feature is absent in AM. The bandwidth of FM is given as 2 times delta plus FM, while the bandwidth of AM is given as 2 times FM. In FM, bandwidth is large, while in AM, bandwidth is small. In FM, space wave is used for propagation, while in AM, ground wave and sky wave propagation is used. In FM, it is possible to operate several transmitters on same frequency, while AM, not possible to operate more channels on the same frequency. In FM, transmission and reception equipment are more complex, while AM equipments are less complex. So these are the different parameters on the basis of which we can compare the AM and FM. Let us conclude today's session. We have studied the construction of twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. We have also studied the applications of twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cables. We have studied the definitions of AM, that is amplitude modulation, and frequency modulation. Thank you for attending today's session.